It's a little low. Aloha, welcome to the second heavy metal meditation. Ka'imi's going to join me today as we tickle some metal and do some meditation and end with some bowls and things. Hopefully it will be smooth and the sound and the video will work. Never can tell. So I'm always reminded when we do gong work that the gong is very powerful and it has the tendency to move energies in the body. So the invitation is to find a very comfortable space. Grab some water if you haven't already. Plug in headphones if you haven't already, or plug your computers into decent speakers because it will enhance the experience. I'm going to talk a lot shorter than last time and just invite and speak you into a grounded place. So the invitation is to get comfortable, be in a location and a sitting or a laying down place where you can be comfortable for the next bit over an hour. And enjoy the ride. I'm thinking it's going to be a good one. So I invite you to close your eyes, and together we're going to take some very slow, very deep breaths, as deep as is comfortable. And I like to do that by filling up my belly first and dropping my diaphragm to allow my lungs to fill until it's as full as is comfortable, and then to hold it for a count of three or four, and then to gently and slowly, about the same speed as you took the inhale, exhale. And when you get to the bottom, also count three or four before you start the in-breath again. And I'm going to do a couple of those before I continue. I invite you to join me. And the invitation is to continue breathing in this manner as we begin the meditation. And as you do, I encourage you to grow roots. And for me, when I'm laying down, that means that in Hawaii we have a banyan tree, and I love the way the roots grow from the branches and from the base. And I just, if I'm laying prone, as I breathe in, I see roots all along my body moving down into the earth. And if I'm sitting, oftentimes they'll come from the base of my spine and my feet. And with each inhale and exhale, those roots grow deeper into Mother Earth. And for me in this process, my body is also relaxing. I'm scanning a little bit through, and if I find an area that's a little tense, I might breathe into that area and allow a release that releases into the roots, so that as I continue, any areas of tension are given to Mother Earth, where she transforms it into what she needs. And as I continue to breathe and allow those roots to continue to grow deeper and spread wider and really get me firmly attached to Gaia, I sometimes see my crown chakra area open up and allow source energy to drop in, move through, and connect with Mama Earth. And as that light comes in, I find that it forms a channel down through my sushumna, through my spine, through the chakras. And it widens, it gets more and more trunk-like, as it were. And if it encounters any resistance, any tension, it also helps just warm it up and release it so that the energy can flow unencumbered by what's going on with me. As you continue to breathe and get grounded and allow that spirit energy to come in and move through you, it can be helpful to form an intention for the journey that's ahead of you, whether that be an intention for the relief of physical ailment or an intention for your heart to open and expand, for that feeling of universal love to flow in and allow yourself to become that. As we move through this journey, we'll be gonging for significantly longer than we did last time. And then there'll be a bit of silence as we transition to a few other instruments. And then I will invite you to return to your body and to finish out the journey. And then we'll have a few words about how to take good care of yourself, as this will open you up and might leave you a little vulnerable. So it's important to have some aftercare. And we'll talk about that in a little while. So thank you very much for joining us. Relax and have a great journey. Om Takriyasa.
Thank you.
As we begin to return to this time and space, the invitation is to become aware of your breath. No need to alter it, just become aware of your breath. And as your consciousness returns to your beingness, to where you are, I invite you to just become aware of your extremities, of your fingers, your toes. I'd invite you to wiggle your toes. And I always like to stretch my hands wide and then move them a bit. Welcome my consciousness back into them. You might become aware of those roots that you grew earlier. You might be surprised to find just how deep they've gone, just how grounded you've become. I know I feel different. Really appreciating that you chose to join us. If you're here live, if not and you're listening after, just appreciate your energy being in this field. These are somewhat uncertain times. And it feels powerful to me to get together with others in a shared experience. So I thank you for your attention and for your intention that you brought with you today. It seems to me rather important after being with these heavy metal instruments to care of my energy space. For me, this opens energy up. It opens vulnerabilities. It just kind of opens me in. It then becomes important for me to take care of that openness, to honor it, to treat it well, to be around others that will also treat it well. Seems important to me to consume water and good live food. I think the gong, in addition to the emotional effect it has on me, sometimes it releases toxins into my system, and the best way to flush them rather than let them settle back in somewhere else in my body or back where they came from is to just flush, to drink more water than I would, and to bring in nourishment from good live food, to allow my body to replenish and replace toxicity with health, vitality. And in the same way, I like to maybe pay attention and take care of my conscious thoughts. I like to give a little extra kindness towards myself and my little Wayne, that little guy full of awe and wonder who just can't believe a piece of metal can sound like the wind. And just gets all joyful when he watches the edge vibrate. I suspect I'll invite him to stick around and play a little bit as part of my self-care practice. And yours may look totally different, but I think it's a good idea to ask how best to take care of yourself and do that for the next few days, certainly for the rest of the day. So pleased you joined me. Katnimi La. That was sweet, and I feel happy.
My joy.
Not whole. I suspect we'll do this again soon, perhaps next week, Friday. I also imagine that we'll be live streaming Dave Heiss and Dawn this Sunday on Dave's Facebook channel. So love to see you there. Probably 6:30 we'll start. If you get the opportunity on Sunday, what would that be? The 20th. September 20th, 2020. In case you're watching this a few years down the line. Have a blessed, blessed evening. And again, mahalo. Thank you for joining us. Aho. Look, it's exciting. I've got a controlled